So I was sent a question yesterday, and the lady was looking for a way that she could send individual emails complete with attachments from an Excel spreadsheet. Did I know any shortcuts? Well, I didn't know any shortcuts, so I wrote a macro, and this is how I did it. Okay, so basically, I have the email addresses, I have the subject, which would be their account number probably, and the attachments. All the attachments are in one file that are located on my hard drive, and I called that folder statements. And so now I will show you what the code looks like. So this is what my code looks like. I called the sub send mail from Excel, and my edress, which is my email address, is set as a string, same as my subject, same as my message, same as my file name, same as my Outlook app as an object. I set my Outlook mail item as an object. I set my attachments as an object, and path is a string. The path is where my files are located for my attachments. My last row as an integer, attachments as a string, and I sent x as an integer. So because all my headings are on the second row, I set x equals 2. And do while sheet 1, which is where it is, cells x1, which is where the email address is, when it thing around doesn't equal blank, then keep going. So for the rest, I set Outlook equals create object Outlook application, set Outlook mail item equals outlookapp.createitem, set my attachments as outlookmailitem.attachments, and the path is simply where I have the files that I'm going to attach located, and that's exactly what that is. And so the edress is my email address, and I've set it to equals sheet1 cells x, which is the second row to start with, and the first column. The subject is sheet1 cells x, which is the second row, and the second column is my subject, and the file name is my attachments that I'd like to add to this sheet. So it's going to be sheet1 cells 3 or x3. What the attachment is going to be is the path, which I've defined up here, plus the file name, which I've taken from my sheet here. And so now I go outlookmailitem.to, and you put the edress in that you've defined up here. Outlookmailitem cc's blank, blind cc's blank. Outlookmailitem.subject equals subject from up here. Outlook mail item body, and here I just wrote a please find your statement attached, and then I have a carriage return and best wishes. And my attachments dot add, and then bracket, you've defined your attachment here, which is your path and your file name. And Outlook display, so I want to see what it looks like before I send it. And then Outlook mail items dot send, and last row equals last row plus 1, and edress equals nothing, and that's just because I was having problems with it. And then x equals x plus 1, and then you go to the loop and it comes back again. So let's just run through this. So we'll go F8 to step through this. So we go it goes here, it goes through all the definitions, it goes there, and it sets applications. It goes exactly the way I'm wanting it to, and it's defines my path, and there it goes. Okay, and then it's putting all of the right things in the right places here. And so there, it's displaying my email message. So here we have my email address. And the subject is what we have here, and the attachment is the file that I've named here. And so then we have our little body that says, please find statement attached, best regards. And then you'd put, you know, your name on the bottom, I suppose. And so that works perfectly fine. So if you kept on F4ing through it, it would keep going until you ran out of names. I should mention that another thing too. And so that you kept F4ing through it, or F8 through it, And eventually you're going to get to the end and it'll go through the next loop. But then at the very bottom, what I've done is I've set Outlook application to nothing and set Outlook mail to nothing just to clean up everything before I end it. So that's how you send email with an attachment from an Excel workbook. Please subscribe.